Hi everyone, this is Mindy Egan for My Favorite Things, and this video is a part of the Very Crafty Holiday video series for 2021, where we are sharing tons of ideas for your holiday crafting, anywhere from cards to gift boxes. The project that I'm going to be sharing with you today is featuring the mini Slimline outside the box Die-namics. I have really been enjoying creating Slimline cards, so I was really excited to see this outside the box. It is just a fun way to dress up our mini Slimline cards. I'm going to be using the Happy Llamadays stamp set from My Favorite Things. I have here a few images off of that set stamped out in the MFT Extreme Black ink, and I like to use 80-pound white cardstock to do my Copic coloring. I'm keeping the coloring of the llamas fairly simple by just doing some dot coloring, which means I grabbed three Copic markers. I have W3, W2, and W0 to do my llamas, and I'm just adding little dots in areas that I would typically add shadows to if I were to be coloring and blending the colors together. But this is just adding a little bit of texture to it, and it's really quick and easy to do. For the rest of the image, I'm going to be using a variety of reds, greens, and kind of a teal color. So for the scarf or for the piece on the back of the llama, I just switched it up between the llamas. I also gave them kind of a peachy looking muzzle, so I believe I used like an E21 or an E11. I kept the shading really quick and simple because it is kind of a smaller area, so it's easier to just add one color with maybe one darker color for the shading. So I went through and added all those colors to the scarf and the pieces on their back, and then I will move on to the cactus. I have two of them stamped here, and then later on I am going to stamp two more and color them off screen because I needed to kind of fill my scene in more. But I colored the other two the same way as I'm doing these two. So I have G28, G07, and YG01. Now I did try my best to color around the lights that are hung on there, so when I'm doing that, I try to hold my marker straight up and down as much as I can to get that very tippy point of my marker, so that way I'm not getting the lights, and then I just took a light yellow and colored those in as best as I could. Then I'll line up the coordinating dies, hold them in place with a low tack tape, and run them through my die cut machine, and then I can move on to working on the actual box portion of the card. So the main portions of this box card is going to be this rectangle, and then there is a dotted rectangle that's a little bit smaller that you can use to decorate your back panel. I will be using the My Favorite Things Red Hot cardstock, so I'm die cutting that rectangle and then also that longer strip. You will need two of those, and for that stitched one to decorate the background, I am using this cool Collab 6x6 paper pack. I love this color combination in this pack, so I thought this would be really fun to use. So I die cut that stitched rectangle, and there's also other ones you could see off on the left hand side that are just another decorative panel that you can use for the side of your box and the front of your box. So those cardstock pieces that I had die cut, those larger ones that we have two of, there are some scored lines on there that the die creates, and I just folded along those lines and reinforced it with my bone folder. Now I'm just decorating my panel, so I added my striped, which has the stitched edge to it, onto my back panel. This also has a stitched detail to it that I'm adding to that front panel, and then also the sides. Now on these longer pieces or these thicker pieces, this is the front that I have that decorative stitching on, and we also have one for the back. So I only decorated the one side of it. That smaller tab here, I'm lining with some double-sided score tape. You could possibly use a tape runner or liquid glue, but I prefer the double-sided tape because it doesn't take any time to dry. I just kind of push down and burnish that into the cardstock, make sure it's stuck really well. And before I attach any of my sides, I'm going to get my back panel attached. So I lined the back strip there with some tape runner, and then I'm taking that large rectangle and just adding it right on top, kind of flush with the bottom of that, folding over the sides just to make sure that that folds over really well. So that is the back panel of our card. Here is how that's going to look with our decorated strip on the front. I'm going to take that smaller tab and butt it right up against the edge of my back panel. Then I can remove the backing of that double-sided tape, butt that up, and fold that over. So that's attaching our front part of our box to the back. Now, these are smaller strips that are also in that die set that we are going to put in the inside of our box card. I die cut 3, but I technically only used 2. There really isn't a lot of room, so I didn't need too many of them. But these also have scored lines on them that I just folded over, reinforced that fold with a bone folder, and then I'm lining each of those tabs with some double-sided tape. Now I can insert these into the center of my box so you can see I don't have my box fully enclosed yet. I'm removing the backing on just one side of that tab. I'm going to line that up with the top of my box. You could put it down a little bit further if you prefer. I just line the top of those strips with the top of that outside of the box there. So I just push that down. I have that folding over. And now I have my second one that I remove the backing on that foam or that double-sided tape as well, kind of gave it a little bit of space between my back tab and then lining that and pushing that down as well. So we have both of those strips now attached just on the one side. Now that bigger strip that is the front of our box, I'm going to attach this first. So I remove the backing of that. I kind of have that folded down flat, and then I'm going to kind of just slowly push this up to form that box and line that up with the side of my box. Now those strips, I'm kind of just slightly, you can see, peeking those out from the top. I remove the backing on those strips as well and attach that to the side of the box. So now our box is completely formed. And you can see I'm just moving this side to side, kind of pushing down on those folds. This will fit into a mini slimline envelope perfectly once it is flat. And then when the recipient pulls it out, it'll pop up to form this really cute box card. So this goes together just like any of the other box cards that MFT has. It's just that it's in a mini slimline version, which I think is super cute, and I'm really glad they did this because I do just like having that variety of card size. Now I'm going through and just attaching my llamas and my cactus to kind of decorate the scene, and I'm just using some liquid glue at the very bottom. There are also some pieces that you could use to die cut out some acetate if you wanted them to kind of pop up a little more, but I just added them right to my card. I have a sentiment here that I stamped off screen, and this is from the Happy Llamadays stamp set as well that I just trimmed down to a thin strip and I'm adding to the front of my card using a tape runner. Now, after I kind of sat and looked at my card, I had a big space in the back that I really wasn't sure what to do with. So off screen, after I was done filming, I did cut out a stitched hillside from white cardstock and added that to my background. And I also did another cactus that I colored and then used a tape runner to add just to kind of fill in that scene a little bit. And there we have this cute little scene with our mini slimline outside the box. I hope you enjoyed today's video. Thank you so much for joining me, and I'll see you again real soon.